So you guys football fans here? UT, right? I'll tell you my favorite thing. One of my friends is from Austin. She's big UT. Big UT fan. She's hardcore. Like, yeah, I'm going to UT, guy. So this is one of my favorites. This just encapsulates everything about just Austin. So she lives in Los Angeles now. So back in the day of the Rose Bowl, when it was UT versus USC, and it was, it was like one of the sickest games ever. It was Vince Young versus Leinart, I believe. So this is the sickest game. So she goes, I'm going, me and my friends are going. We're going to the game. I was like, that's awesome, it's gonna be a sick game. She goes, I know. She goes, I'm going, we're gonna tailgate at like 6 a.m. I was like, bold move, but you know, why not? It's a Rose Bowl. This is my favorite. So the next day, the game was insane, insane. So I call her, I'm like, oh my God, how did you just flip out? I go, I'm a huge sports fan. I would have lost it if my team did that. She goes, I passed out. I go, wait, please tell me you went to the game. Nah, pregame too hard. I go, really? I passed out in my truck and I woke up and it was 5 in the afternoon. I was like, you fucking idiot! She's like, I know, whatever. At least we won. I was like, she just goes and just rages so hard. This is like one of the best games. I don't know. I mean, I tailgate in pregame too, but you gotta make the game. It's a huge part of the whole thing. So like I said, I'm from Minnesota, and I'm a diehard Minnesota Vikings fan. Diehard. Sports is my life. I love sports more than anything. People that don't like sports, you're fucking idiots. It doesn't make sense to me. I have friends who are like, I'm not a big sports fan. I'm like, cool. Lose my number. So I'm at a charity event a couple years ago, and the guy who runs the event comes up to me. He goes, hey man, there's a guy here who wants to meet you. He's a huge fan. I go, cool, who is it? He goes, you're not gonna believe this. It's the quarterback for the Green Bay Packers, Aaron Rodgers. So I go, no, fuck that. That's a true story. And the guy goes, what? You don't want to meet him? I go, no, just tell him I left. Just make something up. And he goes, you can't do that. It's a charity event. I can't just lie to people at a charity event. I'm like, damn. He goes, what's your problem? I go, I'll tell you my problem. I go, I'm going to meet him. And he's going to be really cool. And I'm really cool. So I'm going to be really cool back. Then we're going to do shots. We're going to have some laughs. Then we're going to become friends. Then I won't hate the Packers anymore. And then my life is fucking over. So he goes, you can't do that. You're an idiot. So I'm like, all right, fine. So I meet him, and that's what we became really good friends. He's a really good guy. And now I don't hate the Packers as much, and it really sucks. So I try to channel my energy into some other team. It doesn't make sense. I'm like, yeah, take that, the Chiefs. It's like not the same at all. But I'll tell you this. I told you that story to preface this one. It's one of my favorite stories. So I go, Aaron calls me up one time. He goes, hey, are you going to be in Minnesota for the Vikings-Packers game? I go, yeah. He goes, you want tickets? I go, yeah. That's the main reason I'm friends with you. So he goes, you want to get dinner the night before? I'm like, yeah, totally. So we go to the hotel, get dinner. So we're eating, and this woman comes up. She's about 70 years old, sweet woman, comes up to the table. She's like, hey, I'm sorry to interrupt. Aaron, we're from Green Bay. We drove in for the game. We're so excited. You know that stupid fuck accent? Minnesota is the same one, so I'm also shitting on myself there, so in my defense. So she goes, we're coming to the game. Kick some A tomorrow. And he goes, thank you so much. It's very sweet of you. It was really nice. And he turns to me and he goes, this is my friend. Right away, I just go, wide receiver, Brad Stevens. And then this woman, without missing a beat, just goes, I know you, Brad. I'm like, you've seen me in the end zone a couple times, right? She goes, oh yeah, I've seen you. You score tomorrow, Aaron, throw him the ball. Get him the ball. So now I'm in the fucking NFL, which is amazing. I've done no training, and I'm in the NFL. So she goes, all right, thank you guys, like goes away. And then Aaron turns to me and is like, what the hell was that? I go, I don't know, bro, but throw me the fucking ball. Because I will be wide open. And I thought it was funny, and then I felt bad, because this woman's gonna go back to her family, this poor old woman, and be like, I was at dinner, and I saw Aaron Rodgers, and I don't know, wide receiver Brad Stevens. And her family's gonna be like, that's not a real guy. Yeah, Brad Stevens, the wide receiver. Yeah, he's on the roster. That guy doesn't exist. Yeah, I saw him. He was eating food with Aaron. I saw him. Like, no, that's not a real person. And they're gonna like turn to their family and be like, we gotta put her in a home, dude. Yeah. That's it. That's the last straw. This poor old woman's gonna get taken away. Like, I saw Brad Stevens! I saw him! You're hurting me! All because I'm a foolish idiot.